Well, it is a beautiful day, and I just got some parts in, so let's see if we can possibly knock this out. So this is my 2017 Fusion Sport, and I just got a new intercooler that is going to go right in there, replace the factory one. The one I got was the CPE. It is the only one on the market that I saw that had cast in tanks. Kind of wish I would have gotten one of the other ones because it literally took 4 months for it to show up, but I'm not complaining yet. It is the biggest one on the market. So let's see if we can get this bumper cover off. And luckily it comes with some sweet instructions, so I'm not going to go through all the details of exactly what you need, but obviously you're going to need 8 mil, 10 mil, 13 mil, a whole bunch of sockets and stuff. So if you order this, you'll get the instructions. But let's see what we can do. So first you're gonna remove these six 10 mil bolts to try to get the bottom part of this off. So that came out very easy. Holy crap. And then on each side, you're gonna have three of these 7 millimeter bolts in here. All right, so now on each side there should be six of these push pins. One, two, three, four, five, and then I guess six way up the top. At least that's what they're saying. And then there are these two 10 millimeter nuts. We're gonna take that off camera because my other side is missing a whole bunch of push pins and all kinds of stuff, and I don't have a good tripod, so let me get that stuff loose. All right, here's a word to the wise. Your factory retainers are supposed to look like this. It's a two-piece thing. Every Ford, almost every car on the planet uses those. If you see these things, these obnoxious things that break because they're super long and there's just a huge Christmas tree, that means somebody's been in there and replaced them with different retainers. I already know this car has had body work, so just you know, these things come out pretty easily. These things will fight you, so I'm gonna have to find some new push pins, but that's okay because the other side is just completely missing a bunch of them. And on this one, the there's two of these on each side. One of them, they put it on and it somehow went through, so it's on there, it's just on the other side of this thing. I don't know if they put it on first or what, but oh man, sometimes it sucks working on other people's crap. All right, so once you've gotten those six out, you really don't need to take the top one out either, but I'm just following the instructions. So there's two of these bolts, they're gonna be here and here. So the first one's gonna be real close, like right here, and the next one's gonna be up in there. This is a great place for one of these powered ratchets because it's got a small ratchet on it. And then I didn't take this liner all the way apart because I don't like to risk bending the inner lip that's right here. So I only brought it back just a little bit. So I'm gonna make sure I pop that back up in there when I go to put this all back together. So now I'm gonna move to the other side. All right, once you've gotten the two bolts on each side out, and all the pins and the wheel wells out to get those two bolts out, you're going to take this panel off. and that's gonna be 9 push pins. These little push pins, wait, these little push pins right here. Yeah, and these. Once this is off, there's gonna be 5 10mm, and that's the last thing holding it on other than the two harnesses that you have to disconnect, and I think those are both on the driver's side. All right, so once that panel's off, you take the 5 other ones off. And here's a word to the wise. When you go to take these out, you pull it down because there are these two alignment tabs. I didn't know that on this side. I just kind of pulled straight out and they both sheared off, but it'll be all right. They'll line up good enough. All right, so now I'm gonna have to get Billy to help me. So we're gonna try to take this off, and I gotta get these two connectors off, and I think you can get them from the bottom, so I'm gonna try that. Okay, so you can pull this off by yourself. I will just caution to be careful with the top two corners. You bring it out just a little bit, and then this small harness is connecting right here, and it's gonna be real stretched. So if you can get one hand on it while holding this in the center with the other hand, you can push that tab down just enough to pull it without ripping this. Just be careful. And then this other one, so what I had to do, this duct kind of, this was kind of over top of it. This duct was pushing up on this fog light plastic. So you kind of move it from up here over to where this harness is down here, and then it's actually buried right here. So you see the connector right there. So that you can get in there, it's the same kind of tab. Just push that tab, slide it off. So there we go, bumper's off. That's the probably the hardest part, or the most annoying part. Okay, so it's off. This is your ducting. This ducting is not going back on from what I understand. This is how I know somebody's been in here. Your ambient temp sensor is supposed to be right here, but for some reason they plugged it in on the back side when it clearly goes right there. But that's okay, because this kit includes a laser cut bracket for that to go onto. So that's your ambient temp sensor. That's how your car knows what temperature it is outside. So this is gonna have four bolts, and then it's supposed to have 4 trim clips. Another sign that somebody was in here who didn't know what they're doing. These 4 clips on the bottom are supposed to go through into the plastic, but they were just not even in there. So at least it's gonna be easy to take off. And then I guess there are supposed to be 2 more trim clips on the sides somewhere, but I'm not seeing them. Oh well, this is coming off. Yep, and then there's your factory intercooler. So that's what we're gonna be replacing. So the next step's gonna be to loosen the inlet clamps, which are 7mm or a flathead, or the outlet clamp and the inlet clamps. They're all gonna be 7mm or a flathead. And then I guess there is a harness for the MAP sensor right there that you're gonna take off. And then we're gonna be doing some stuff. I guess we're gonna pull driver's side headlight out. Driver's side? Yeah, I don't know. We're gonna be pulling a headlight out so that we can get room to get the intercooler out of there. So once you've got the 2 inlets and the outlet clamps loosened, there's going to be some 8mm bolts. So those are 7s, and the ones that are actually holding it in are 8mm. All right, so we're actually removing the passenger headlight for the cold side charge pipe. So there's going to be 1 T25 Torx and 2 10mm bolts right here on the top of the headlight. There are 2 more below the headlight, and then the harness. So my guess is gonna be these 2 right here, and then we take the harness off. So we're gonna rip that headlight out. All right, once you got the headlight out of there, there is a 1 single 8mm bolt in there for that charge pipe, and then we should be able to pull all the charge pipes off and yank the intercooler out of there. All right, so as you see, there's this hook. So you gotta get someone to help you. They'll grab that pipe over there and pull up. And you gotta pull this hook up and it gets real close to your AC line right there. And then so once you've pulled it up and kind of tilted it back out, and it'll come straight down, then you gotta pull it off the tube. So there's our intercooler out. And it looks like it's about half the size of the one we're putting back into it. And now's a good time to see how much oil is in your intercooler. See if your catch can's working. So as you can see, that is a massive difference in size on that new intercooler from CPE versus the factory one. So you can use that same T25, take out this bolt right here. This is your MAP sensor. Just be careful with it. It's just got a little O-ring, you gotta pop out. Oh, she's in there a little bit. Okay, there's your MAP sensor. I'm just gonna transfer it over to this one. Put it back. So here's your hardware kit. The screw that comes out isn't gonna go back in, it's just made for plastic. So the screw for your MAP sensor is this M6 by 18. All right, and you've got 8 M6 by 12s for the 4 brackets that are included in your kit. And then you've got a 1/4-20, a Nylock, and 2 flat washers. And those are for the some other crap, I don't know. But this is for your MAP sensor, so make sure you use that. Okay, so the brackets are gonna go on like this. You got the top one. This is actually your passenger side. The top one right near the MAP sensor is the one that curves out and up. This one's facing straight down. And then over here you got your big curved one, which for some reason I had an extra of. And then this one goes straight out to the side. And we put some red Loctite on that one before we drove them in. So now we're gonna put them in. So I guess they said the passenger upper mount right here is gonna have this 1/4-20 through bolt that came in the kit with some washers and a Nylock. All right, so it's on there. Here's a couple tips. So the intercooler won't sit back far enough. It hits this lip right here. So even if you have the brackets on, they're not going to line all the way up with the tabs. So you're going to have to crank them down. It's going to bend them just a little bit, but don't go too crazy with it. And then this one that they say to do a through bolt, I had to stick it through from this side and pry off of this to push it through the hole. And I'm not able to get a fastener in there or a bit in there to hold it from this side. So basically when you have it off, get like a 1/4-inch drill bit, drill through that so that you don't hit any resistance. And then you can put it through from the back side and put the nut on the inside. Once it's tight, it won't come loose because it's a Nylock. But she's on there nice and tight. And definitely make sure you don't fold over the edges of your boost tubes. Make sure that they're on the right side of the lip, the bead, and there we go. And then don't forget your little bolt in here to hold this boost tube, and then you put it back together. So I'm gonna start putting it back together. So at this point, you should probably start double checking that you get that you have the right hardware for everything. So there's the one bolt for the boost tube that secures it underneath the headlight, which is why we took the headlight out. You've got the 3 factory bolts that go back in to hold the intercooler. Make sure that you tighten both of your boost tubes, or all 3 of your boost tubes. Make sure you get your through bolt for the upper bracket on this thing. Make sure those brackets are tight. Put your headlight back in, which will have 5 bolts, 2 here, 2 down here, and then your 1 Torx right here. And make sure that it plugs back in, that you plug the headlight back in. And then once you get to this point, this thing is not going back on. It's just a duct for the factory stuff, and you're not using it because we got this massive intercooler here now. So from here on out, it's relatively easy. You put everything back together. Make sure you put this on. It just uses a couple of these factory hardware, and that holds your ambient temp sensor. So I'm going to work on putting the bumper back on and